Right, let's start the recording. Okay, so we are all set up. We are all set up for streaming. It's absolutely fine. Let's just spread the knowledge on this Twitter. Cool. Okie dokie. Cool. So in terms of that, we've got like a first thing to do, which is asking people to just join the stream on Twitch. Let's start with the project itself. So the project is quite not really sophisticated thing. It's like a tool for presentation things that you're going if you're going to present things. That's the exact problem that I faced. That if I'm trying to starting to making a presentation, I've got no idea what people are actually thinking about it. It's absolutely fine to get the feedback when people are actually saying that, well, I liked that, I liked this and stuff in yada yada yada, but I think you should fix that bit up. And it's like fine, but as far as I know, and as far as my experience is going, is like and especially as a being an audience rather than being a presenter. It started to be like, well, maybe that's not the best thing. I couldn't remember the every single detail underneath the presentation. I remember that it started to be like, well, you talking shit or stuff like that. But at the end of the presentation, it was like, I've got no idea what was happening there. So I thought that, well, maybe the entire thing will be necessary in terms of having like a right tool to getting the feedback as it is, as it goes, rather than having the feedback like, well, that's maybe something that I can live with it. But I couldn't remember what the guy was talking about and stuff like that. So I was no, not really. So I thought that way. Hey, maybe there should be a kind of tool that I can vote unlimited times during the presentation and getting the feedback as it is. So I was like, all right, fine. Let's do that. Let's do that. Let's write it down. And let's do it obviously open source because I'm a fucking open source freak. And I was like, fine. Right. So, here's my 3 or 4 day, well, hours of working, and essentially I've created the first scaffold of that kind of solution. So I've covered already the user scenario that we'll go through in a second, But it was all about that, to provide the tool that I can just, during the presentation, I can click unlimited t times on a, that's fine, that's fine. Keep going, mate. Or the otherwise, that's dull. I hate it. It's really, you're talking shit. And in order to get that feedback, just sort it out in a timeline, we can say that what exact thing it cost. So I will go through through the code a bit, because it's like, yeah, I should get some sort of view after such time, because I live left it for maybe 3 or 4 months, because of absolutely different topics happening around me. And let's go through that. Let's go through the code. Let's go through the tests. I think the test would be the best thing in the first place. And after that, let's add another feature, which is getting an information as a hopefully child, but we will see how it goes. Okay, so let's start from the beginning. Let's start from the tests, obviously, because everyone starts from the test, right? No, not really, but yep. Let's go through it. Let's go through the first thing. So I've got like a first thing, which is voting test, and the voting test is all about having the right, the core of the entire project. So we've got like an information that test like scenario, test dislike scenario, test reading starts without voting. So that's the most specific one, I think. And the next one is test readings with positive vote, yada yada yada, right? But it's some sorts of more sophisticated things, and we've got like recurring repository. We'll get to that. So let's start from the easiest one, test like scenario. So it's like we are getting a just a regular person, which will be the audience, right? And we are having the recording repository, which is recording the information that's happening behind the scene. And there is a voting facade. The facade is something that I would consider as entry point for the handling of the voting itself, like a function. And during that, we are handling the vote, which is the voting thing. So the facade is going to get saying that, hey, I'm allowing you to do the voting, and the voting has a time, so where that was happened, and that it does was positive or negative. So that's the only thing that we are handling here. And the third thing is if that's going to be what kind of listener. So what we are trying to achieve here is like we've got a session, and during that session, every single user having own actionable items, like going through the I'm voting that, or I'm not voting that things up. And the entire thing is based on that reaction is something, well, important. So there is no neutral reaction, because that doesn't make sense at all. Okay, so I can vote, and if I'm voting positively, I'm getting the information that is that's going to be recorded as a repository. If that's happening actually. So if I'm saying that, well, that vote is positive or it's negative, and I'm getting that kind of information from recording repository. Okay, that kind of simple thing. So in terms of that scenario, and surprise, surprise, this is what's happening here. It's something that is happening through the facade, which is absolutely fine. But I've got the same scenario on the integration tests, but the first thing that I would like to do is to run the application so far that what we've got right now. Let's run. It's obviously a Spring application because Spring is all about. I'm not pretty sure that if that's the best choice I've made, but let's see about that. Right, so this application is very, very pretty straightforward. It's like so far it's not very desktop friendly. However, it's like something that you probably will use with the application. So essentially that's having the most important idea, which is clicking if that's all right or if that's a bloody bullshit, which is mostly probably something that people will click on, but I would rather to see a statistic thing about that. So in order that if I'm clicking on that thing, I'm getting just information that it's fine or it isn't so far. So that's, as I said, that's a pretty scaffold thing, and I've actually have a database behind that, but we will see about that later on, obviously, because that's not a really important thing right now. And right, let's stop it for a while. Right, so this is the entire thing about that. So it's like I don't want to hear about the details so far. What I want to hear is user story, right? As some sort of user story. I'm not pretty sure do you like that or not so far, but because we are starting. So that's something that we'll go through later on. Okay, so here's something that I just explained in my latest blog post, and the entire problem with testing and the entire problem with having the test properly created is like I should create. So people are actually scared a bit of creating additional classes, additional test classes, and it's like no, I'm done fucking doing it. No, it's like it's increasing the complexity every single time I'm doing that. So I will keep tests as simple as possible, and that's essentially not true. Well, that might be true, but honestly, during the first iterations that you're doing, probably you're not doing it wrong. Probably you do need classes that are actually used during the testing only, so that's absolutely fine. And there are a lot of publications about that. So Uncle Bob, which is Robert C. Martin, is writing that well, you probably do need separate testing API, which is something that will create some sort of bridge between your tests and the implementation, so you're not relying on the implementation directly. You've got like another thing to do. So I've got like a plain person, which is listener DTO. So listener, maybe that's not the best naming I've created here, but listener is a person that can handle. It's actually listening to the presentation. So he can or she can give a feedback about that. What's happening? Is that dual or is that all right? So yeah, so that's the first class that we've got here. And the voting test is, as I said, there are a few scenarios. Let's run the test, by the way. Are they running? It's like yeah, it's like having the listening to the presentation, well, a presentation or speech created and performed by Uncle Bob especially, and he when he was saying that, well, the entire tests are very, very important, so you have to write them one. But it's like, hey mate, are you really writing this test, or are people around you just writing them? It's like, yeah, if you're not showing that these are actually working or not, it's like, who cares, honestly? And that's the entire problem with software engineering, by the way. It's like it's not a science, definitely. It's not an engineering neither. It's like a thing that we are just having a hunch, and during the hunch we are trying to sort things out, but it's probably not the best way to sort out things, especially if we know that, for example, architecture, well, the building architecture is something that is an actual science, right? And they're based on very, very strong physical things, and they're based on physics, obviously, not a physical things, although I think they are as well. But yeah, that kind of thing. The entire thing, the medicine, is really based on science. It's not based on hunch. Even if they're still trying to prove their own view. But yeah, this is the entire thing. So the software engineering, definitely broken thing. Yeah, and we don't have proofs that, apart from that, hey, our software working, but is the Scrum working, for example? No, it isn't. No, it is. And that's the entire problem with the industry. However, yeah, the tests are working. Tests are working. They're going through. So the first pack is voting test, which is testing for the entire domain, well, the bundled context that I've got for Sateful. The second thing is acceptance scenarios, which is the entire thing that we are talking about, the integration thing, which is essentially, I think that was, we can't say from here, but we'll look at the web GUI, and turns out that it's actually Selenium driver, and this last thing, which is save to disk repository. So we've got a repository that is saying methods. Okay, so I know that the entire thing is pretty clunky, but we'll get to that. It's quite it isn't that complicated. However, it's a little complex, as the every single program is, or at least supposed to be. Alrighty, brighty. So let's go to the production code. Production, yeah. My eyes, production. Anyway, we've got a few repositories. So we've got Volta. The Volta has few actions, which the actions are add vote and the rejected vote, some sort. So that's an information that it's the voting is really rejected, and there is the entire thing. Home. Where's the voting facade? All right. So the voting facade, and that's the problem. It shouldn't be the only thing that it's public. However, it's the repository is public, as long as it has just repository that it's sorting out the thing. So to it's like it's something that I will call, well, and the entire, hold on, turn the light on, because that's going to be an arcanite. Anyway, yeah, so the entire thing is that we've got a repository, and the repository and the entire architecture is built like a port adapter. So we've got a thing like facade, which is something that it's going to sort out the thing, the entire vaulting thing. So this is an input, right? So that's going in. However, we've got a thing that is called repository, and that's the other interface that you're going to say that, hey, that's some sort of adapter that I'm gonna to implement in order to get something working. That kind of simple thing. And the example of that implementation is Alzheimer repository. And I'm not just making fun of the people with Alzheimer, absolutely not. But the entire thing is Alzheimer syndrome. But the entire thing is that I've got a repository, a Vault repository, that is going to forget of things, and it's absolutely built in memory. So yeah, it's forgetting things as once it's going to be destroyed, or collected, as people will say. Well, the garbage will be collected. Whatever, that's a figure of speech. I hope so. Cool. So that's the repository thing. The other thing, I would say, is quite important, is a voting repo for site, but we are not getting there yet. It's like it's something that I would like to have, but it's not yet implemented, and we will get to that. We'll be the build the entire implementation as long as we are going to program a bit. But I have to go through the entire thing, unfortunately. Cool. So where we are here. So I've got a vote result. So essentially, let's go through the voting of a site once again. So during the voting, when I'm doing the voting, and where's the test for it? Voting test. All right. So here's the thing, first thing. So if I'm voting, essentially, I should get the reply that will say that, hey, that's you, that's something that you're doing is right, and it's going to be accepted. Or there is a some sort of rule that I don't care at this point that will say to you that, hey, it's not going to work. Okay, so let's do the a bit of change. So I would like to say that, hey, I really do care about the results, and I know that the assertion here. The another assertion is something that no one should do, yeah. Yeah, I don't care at this point. Is it? Yep. Cool. Is it working right now? I hope so, but right. So that's something that's happening. So I'm getting an information for that the voting was accepted because of some sort of rules that might be not get accepted, but we will get to that as soon as possible. Right. So here's the another thing. And the entire voting is based on checking of how repository is actually getting stored. So recording repository, whoops. So recording repository is an abstraction, well, in concrete class, I think. I hope so. Yeah, that's something that's is implemented as almost as an Alzheimer. But yeah, Alzheimer is an actual production implementation, let's say. But the entire thing with recording repository is some sort of just definition that it's going to store only one voting record, which is absolutely fine for the testing here that we are creating, and that's a part of the testing as well. So as you can see, there is no information that's going to be shared between classes as this public one, even if that's a part of the testing, right? So many people are saying that, well, I don't really care about the access modifiers within the testing, but I would say like, it's probably if you're treating your production code as a production code, and that's quite serious thing, right? That's a serious business. So you should also think about having the same approach for your testing code, because the problem is that you don't have tests for your test, and you should have and you should prevent the information on the on the testing. So you have to be 100% sure the tests are doing the thing that they're supposed to do, rather than and they are actually able to be changed during the time, and you've got the entire thing about the solid principles and stuff like that, rather than having shit around there. So yeah, that's all right. Yeah, enough of mumbo jumbing things. Let's go to the so that's the entire thing in terms of like it's going to be some sort of class representation. So let's go to the implementation, rather than interfaces. So the interface has two things. So the voting facade, which is the first thing. So we've got like voting facade for making votes. Quite pretty simple thing. And the other thing is voting report facade. We'll get to that, but that's a report that you can create during the after and during, hopefully, during the voting procedure. So during the presentation, we'll get to that as well. Right. And yeah, and the entire implementation is like, well, there is a saving result. So we are doing the save in the repository. So we are saying that, hey, repository, just store that data for us. There is no really quite important bit here, but we are trying to not leak the results information, so if that's going to be committed or not, and we're saying that, well, if that's committed, that's, let's say that it's committed, but it's all right, it's acknowledged, and if that's not the case, that let's do the reject vote to inform the end user, the back, the front end, sorry, the front end user, that it's not going to use that kind of thing, and the vote is getting rejected because of some reason. We don't know what the reason are so far, but we'll get to that as well during the implementation. It's like 3-4 hours work, so that's not something I would say that it's advanced. Cool, and we've got like statistics. So the method about statistics is give me all information about that so far, and just do the streaming to just get how many actual things are getting through. So how many votes happened so far? I'm not pretty sure that's covered in the test yet, but I've got a hunch that it should be covered soon. Hope so. So yeah, so we've got like a vote data, which is yeah, and that's the other thing with DDOs. I think that's very useful. Hold on. Right. So I don't think that I was a few years ago, I was like, maybe the DDOs are absolutely something that you don't need in your project, and the entire literature is just wrong about that, and we don't need that kind of thing. But it turns out I'm wrong. Nothing special, honestly, nothing surprising. It's all about maybe making mistakes and making bad assumptions and being just fixed about that. So it turns out that it's quite important, that's quite relevant thing, that we have to have a data transfer object. The data transfer object is going to be quite dull and quite stupid, and it's going to be a dummy object that it's going to just get the information through, which is fine. Yeah. So I had to implement that kind of static things. As you can see, they are private, so it's not getting leaked once again through the API. So if you'll think about how the API is going to be stored, it's quite of, I would say that it's not very common a pattern yet. In software engineering, especially in Java, that you've got few bits exported, few bits are getting just visible, and the other ones are going to be hidden by private or packet scope, and yeah, and that's something that we should think about later on. I mean, it's fine to have, because the entire thing is that we are going to do, as just Java developers, we are creating packages, like going to say that it's going to be, these are going to be servlets, these are going to be data objects, these are going to be models, whatever, or services, yada, yada, yada. Many, many things that are getting to be put into bags that represent specific tools, rather than these things should be like representatives for things that they're doing, right? So if I'm going to, so for example, if I'm going to have some sort of functionality, let's say in this case, we are going to have like, I don't know, maybe profile for a voter, right? So the specific person that is going to vote, it has to have own profile. And the wrong thing about that would be like creating a specific service, specific DTO, specific all the thing, and putting it into different packages, making it public, because I have to make it public, obviously, and just trying to communicate between them. And after that, if I'm just deciding that, well, it's not maybe the best thing to do, and I'm going to remove these classes. It's going to be like poof, 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 removing every from every single package, and the entire thing will look like it's spread across the entire application. So, assuming that obviously Conway's law, that we are going to have a different, we are creating a different layers of sophistication, right? Different layers of complexity, and organization is coming in, and the actual implementation reflecting at the end of the day, it's reflecting the organization of creation, that kind of thing, that kind of software. So we are getting a big mess about the entire thing, because we are not putting the tools into different drawers. It's not that kind of the same thing. It's not workshop. It's not hardware workshop that we are making. It's an actual software development. And in software development, we are thinking about features. We are thinking about how it's going to be done, how it's going to handle things, rather than it's going to be something. So, yeah. So, enough of Mambo Jambo. Let's go to the most important bit, someone will say, but let's go to the Alzheimer repository for a while. So Alzheimer is pretty simple. It's based on the list of votes, and the list of votes is going to be a linked list. I'm not pretty sure why I haven't put that. Let's do that kind of thing. Yep, back. Move forwards, give me a equals, fine. Forget about this. Right. Redundant sorted call, subsequent count, call doesn't bend the sum to order. Yeah. Right, but I don't really care as long as all tests are passing. Yeah, integration tests. I'm gonna to keep them as low as possible. I mean, like, one, maybe two scenarios for getting the information, because what's the important bit in the application. So how I think about the integration tests. So integration tests should be like, the first thing is to get the most important things done. So in this application, the most important feature is to get votes recorded. That there is nothing else that it's that important. So I can get a broken information about how we are displaying the votes, how we are displaying the statistics. That's absolutely fine. I mean, that might be broken. That might be broken just from scratch, and no one will. Well, obviously, if we'll get an information that, well, that's not working, and that kind of thing, we are able to set a fix for that. However, if you are not going to have the voting stored during a presentation, which is a very, very kind of important thing, it's like, no, that's not going to work. I mean, it's fine for just a few things, few bits, from the reading thing. So the reading might be broken, but the writing thing, and that the most important writing thing, which is going through and voting for the presentation, shouldn't be broken. So we are covering that with tests. Right. So that's something that I've just work around. Well, it's not a rock around. I'm really curious why I've created the default constructor in the first place. Probably because of I wanted to store here something else. But yeah, fresh view, isn't it? Yeah, fine. I wonder why I've created sorted, because sorted doesn't mean anything, right? Here. It's like why should sort that up? No. Let's run test once again. I probably would get rid of the integration test soon, but let's make it what it is so far. Yeah, and the entire thing that it's happening on as a log, like it, just like it, that's definitely a bad approach. So I have to replace that with logger. So let's do a bike shedding once again, because it's all about bike shedding. Cool. But that's not a part of this implementation. That's probably the entire thing in a controller. So yeah, so this is the point that I would say that's going to be like an adapter. So default adapter, maybe default ports and default adapters. So what I've got here is the entire voter application, which is going to be a Spring Boot application. And the most important thing here is like I'm not going to store this one is in just the same package that I've created for voter for the entire, let's say, bundled context. It's not entirely bundled context, but bundled. No, bundled context. But yeah, that's going to be it's going to be something. That's going to be something. And inside, it's something related to be a domain object, to have the entire logic based on things that are representing the core value, the value stream maybe of the delivering value, especially delivering value for a project itself. And these things are just the bullshit that has to work behind the scene, right? So this is something that, let's say, we're making money off. Maybe not, but who cares? But these things are just the necessary software that we have to write about handling that things that are coming in and coming out and storing the data, blah, yada yada yada. Not really the best thing to do, but who knows? What's happening? Oh. Huh. Okay, so Carol just Karol pozdrawiam serdecznie. So he just retweets. Oh, the people are actually observing me. All right. Cool. Cheers, everyone. Very appreciate. Very appreciate. Especially that's my first Twitch ever. So that's definitely something that I'm trying to do. I'm pretty sure that I'm doing it wrong in the first place. But hey, it's all about courage rather than trying to do everything in a perfect way in the first place. It's like it's never worked for me. It's like I'm trying to do something perfectly, but it turns out at the end of the day, it turns out I'm doing shit. So In my opinion, something is good, but it isn't. So I don't really bother anymore about that kind of things, and I'm just trying to do something. And after that, I'm going to reiterate after time after time. So yeah, we'll see about that. How it's going to work. Hopefully, it's not going to be that bad that people will unfollow me on Twitter, or they're going to say that tomorrow they're going to spit me on the face. But who knows? Who knows? I like the consensus, honestly. Right. Getting back to the Spring Boot application. So we've got like a voter application shit, which is essentially just a very, very default Spring Boot application. And then there are security settings that I'm saying that, hey, maybe you should go with the information. You should allow the CSS or JS or CSS, for God's sake. There's, yeah, my cat's worth. He's gone mad. Anyway. Oi. He went away. Right, so here's the thing that I'm going to have the so I'm saying that it's fine to serve the root application, it's fine to serve the JSs, CSSs, activator. It's dual idea for from the first time, but it's fine. And yeah, and these are actually two things that I allow here in application, just by default. I'm trying to do a default thing that, yeah, it's going to say that like and dislike, which are different actions, are going to be accepted in REST API. Just keep in mind that these two things, which are like and dislike and going to be a REST request, these are not very quite of tightly coupled with the function that I'm doing underneath. I mean, like, because keep in mind that the entire facade, the voting facade, is not getting the different two different methods. It's actually getting one. So, and that's my point in terms of having the different ports and adapters, trying to implement that bit. In terms of security settings, we'll get to the DM controller in a second. But it's like I can replace here with whatever I want. I can get a SOAP request, right? I can get SOAP. I can get fucking COBOL. Which is quite ridiculous, but the current architecture is saying me, you can't do it. You can do it. You're just replacing that kind of IO thing, and that's absolutely fine. You can use it. How often that should happen? Hopefully never. It's like I've got quite interesting conversation about that. How many times were you changing the database in major application, Java application? So, for example, you're using JDBC, which is just very, very generic API. Let's say that's very generic API because it isn't, but yet it's going to say that, hey, you can replace the JDBC with MySQL. If you're using MySQL, let's go to Postgres. And if you're going to Postgres, let's use the Oracle. And it's absolutely fine to get the different database layer. And it's like, no one fucking changing the database during the work. Of course, there are exceptions. And the exception is, thank God, Jira, which is actually sorting out a few databases, and which is the most important thing, right? And that's something that is actually quite important in that bit. But that's an exception rather than an actual case for every single application. So why we are using JDBC in the first place? We can use just drivers, but yeah, whatever. But in this case, yeah, I can make the ports and adapters replaceable, and the replacement is all about the replacement is not about having things like, hold on. Once again, someone's just bothering me. Cool. These stupid jokes on Slack. Right. So yeah, in this case, it's not about actually replacing the IO thing, but the use case is to have IO separate from a testing perspective. So that's not the best idea to test the ports and adapters itself. It's fine for a few cases, for a few integration tests, but usually you don't want to do this. Especially you don't want to. I don't want it to run the Spring Boot application every single time I'm testing something, right? Lovely. Right, so that's the entire point. Okay, let's move a bit further. So controller, the exact class that is doing heavy lifting. So there are a few, well, a few, my ass, a few. Most of the applications are doing most of the things in controller. So essentially, it's saying that, hey, I'm gonna to sort it out on your behalf, and I'm going to do every single thing you wanna, which is quite dull thing, honestly. So here's the th first thing I can see from how old that code is. Ooh. No, that's something changed. Initial Spring Boot application to vote. Okay, so what's the date? So the date is April. But last year. Okay, yeah, that explains a lot. That explains what I'm thinking about. Who the fuck wrote it? Okay, let's write the is it working? Nope. Do I have a logger? That's an interesting thing. It's like how many people are actually using. So there are two, for God's sake. Yeah, so there are two things that people were using. So a few of them are actually getting the controller class, and most of people are actually using the string literal, so they're just doing the Java whatever controller. I'm not pretty sure which school is better. I think they both have their drawbacks. Honestly, there is no positive as well about there is no positives about logging. Logging is something that we have to do. It's not delivering any. It's not delivering any value anywhere. If someone just if someone is actually disagreeing with that, fine, but it's not something anyone should use anywhere. It's like it's logging. Logging is the thing that we have to do because we need to m monitor our application, monitor the things that we're using, the possible errors that are happening. It's not like someone will need that kind of thing. Alrighty, Brighty, it's going to pass through all these things. Yeah, it's not going to have that kind of thing stored right now, but let's say that I'm going to get something that is not really It's not an error, it's a severe here. I'm just checking out if that's working. Not very professional way, but still something that people can find useful. It's kind of dark here. Is that working? Yep, okay, and there are actually things that are getting stored as a stored as an errors, which is fine, but we are not going to log that thing as an error, but we know that that's working. So that's all right. Okie dokie doke. Right, so this is a controller. So going through a controller, what it's doing is actually just saying that it's an actual adapter for voting facade. So it's getting a listener, and the most important thing here, and I believe that that's an actual hard labor that it's doing here, is like getting the attributes and getting the session ID. So that's an actual logic it's making. It's not it's saying that, hey, this single person is based on the session ID, and we are getting the session ID every single time. So so that's the way we can just distinguish the people, well, the audience, from another, well, I mean, person from another person. Okie dokie doke. So yeah, so that's pretty damn simple thing. And we've got something that I would say that it's a module for improvement of performance, and that's done because I was trying to manage it to put on my first presentation, which turns out that it wasn't the best idea because that wasn't very ready. And the point is that I'm trying to make it working right now for my next presentation that I will give someday. That's a plan at least. Cool. So yeah, so here's the different thing. So it's a decorator. You're probably familiar with the decorator pattern, which is something that's going to get an original object, and it's going to wrap up, well, there might be a wrapper, but it's going to wrap up the methods. And the methods are as follows: getting from repository, from voting repository, which is honestly something that I would like to get rid of, as the parameter optimization is not really suitable for the software engineering approach, as it's not going to get a quick win. And it's all about quick win, isn't it? I mean, like, every single software project is going to be a quick win in the first place. How long are you going to work on it? A month, maybe two, maximum three. Okay, later, a year later, yeah, it's going to be a massive issue. We are not done yet, so yeah, that kind of thing. It's always the same story, isn't it? Yeah, so this is something that I just made a change a year ago probably, and there are a few number of voters and that kind of stuff, but it's going to have the first and most important thing was saving the result DTO, which was saving the entire thing, and it's happening, like, it's going to have a permanent repo, permanent repository, and it's going to add the all items from permanent repository. And the most important thing that is happening, it's going to add a queue. So, but that's magic thing, honestly. It's like I'm adding it to a queue, which is a blocking queue, and that blocking queue in a thread underneath is going to do. No one cares about that at that stage. So it's going to have like I'm going to do an executor. That executor is going to get a queue of saving things, and then actually they're gonna to be saved in a repository. So in terms of thinking about that, it's going to be write-only repository. I don't have to think about I don't have to think about the asynchronization between the database and memory and database in a in storage. So, in terms of that, obviously the storing in a disk and doing that through the request processing is quite hard. So what I'm doing here is to store the task. Well, someone would say that it's a message. Best regards to Greg Young about the entire thing. So I'm going to say save a message and an event here, and the event is going to be stored later on, which we are saying that, well, we are going to handle the request, we are going to put it into queue, but we'll save it later. Obviously, we are not changing the values of the information, so it's like we're going to store this vote regardless of the time it's going to be collected. So it's happening. So the time assignment is happening way before. Okay, cool. So these are quite of dual things. Here's configuration for integration testing. Here's the save to disk repository, which is quite interesting as it is an actual repository, which is using the hold on, I'm just listening to something. Something's happening. All right. So here's a repository, an actual implementation repository, which is based on I suppose that was as SQLite, but let's make sure that it's going to be SQLite. Yeah. Someone will say SQLite. I would say SQLite. No, I would say SQLite. Yeah. Whatever. Anyway, yeah, that's so it's like it's using a connection, it's getting a connection, it's creating table, not every single time. It's like it's initialized and saving. So saving is going to get a connection, which is, will be loaded once. That's supposed to be done per thread, but I'm not pretty sure about that kind of thing. And it's creating a prepared statement, and the prepared statement is essentially something that is going to insert a vote. And vote is going to be saved in a prepared statement, and we are going to return saving the result of DDO. Which will say that, well, it's fine. If that's not fine, we are throwing the runtime exception, which is not the best idea, honestly, but we'll see about that later on. And I'm going through the code right now, and I'm doing just plain refactoring. So my thought is that probably people will be like, why the guy is saying that he will do it later on, that's not important, yada yada yada. And honestly, the most important thing here is to just get loaded the entire context of this program, of this application. Some not many people are actually using the word program anymore, because it's not a patch program, it's an application that is running somewhere, probably in the cloud, but wherever. So that's so I'm trying to sort it out in the first place. I'm going to rev through, and after that we'll add the DM to the presentation. We've got plenty of time yet. It's like, what time is it? Yeah, it's 9, so we've got 2 hours to write some code, so that's absolutely fine. We can go through the code in the first place. This is something that's bad, so we'll cover that these bits in our testing. Cool. So that's integration has accounting and in memory decorator repository. Did I mention that bit? Yes, I did. Store in disk configuration. So here's another thing from coming from well, Spring Boot essentially. So we've got like two configurations, and configurations are saying that, well, we're going to provide the voting facade from the first in the first case, and the second facade we're in our second case we're going to get a report facade, and we are just saying that, hey, it's a configuration, it's done for production and for dev. Why is that? I don't know. But yeah, but we are going to create well, the voting builder, and we'll get to that, is something that is builds up the it's a configurator for domain object, for domain facade, and we'll get to that soon. However, it's going to get the end information about how the data is going to be stored during that. So I cannot build up the voting builder, sorry, the voting facade by myself. What I can do is to create a voting builder and get a facade and get a statistics, voting stati voting reports facade from it, indirectly after building the entire thing, after building the voting builder in the first place, the configuration. So what's the purpose of that? Obviously, it's like I'm going to say this one is particularly, it's going to be a test configuration for the integration testing, and the second one's going to be a production as something. So it's going to store the data within the file rather than being stored in the memory. Okay, so yeah, so that's a store in this configuration. Here's integration testing config. So these two guys are different in terms of the profile, obviously, and the entire thing. So the integration testing config is saying that we're going to use a voting builder, but it's going to be with Alzheimer repository, and that's going to be. That kind of thing. So yeah, so in terms of that implementation, it's a different configurations, but it's done for, as I said, it's going to be done for integration testing in the first place, configuration for something I don't need to store the data in, and the second thing is that I'm going to store this information as it is a production thing. All right, that kind of simple. Pretty simple thing. Someone's just asking me how's going to work. I'm not working right now. All right, cool. So that's the bit of the backend storing stuff. So essentially, what we've got are two things that we are voting in. So let's go to the controller. So let's summarize that bit. It's going to be a controller that is getting the vote liking and vote disliking. Pretty damn simple. And let's go to the front end part, as probably that's something that's most importantly that is getting handled within this bit, right? So awesome bullshit. And how it's going to work. So here I've got resources, and resources have static two files. And someone will ask me, why I'm not using Angular? Well, no. Yeah, and that's the entire thing I'm keep thinking about. It's like when I'm using when I'm doing because the entire layer of that voting process should be as small as possible. So the use cases and user stories, user case, fucking hell. It's like something that I'm going to get the as thin front-end application as possible. So it's going to get few things, two things actually. So the first one is the voting. It's like thumbs up. And the second is that's a bullshit, mate. That's a bullshit. And these are two actions that I'm going to sort out from a front-end perspective. So these two are the only actions that the audience should care. I mean, apart from the getting the right link and stuff like that, right? But yeah, but still. And let's go through the JavaScript code. So we've got like a vanilla JS. It's not going to be an Angular app so far. Probably I should add the React JS and stuff like that inside of it. After that, if that's going to be more template-wise an application rather than being some dual thing. So here we've got a few classes, if we can say about classes in JavaScript. We actually can't, but yeah, some people will say that these are no fucking classes, fuck off. Probably Java developers. And the second ones, which are JavaScript programmers, will say that fuck, these are no classes as well. These are fucking objects, you fucking moron. And I will agree with them as well. I mean, like, yeah, these are for classes for me, and these probably are not classes as a Java programmer should think about. But still, so we've got like a few classes which are local event processor. I've got that's a dull name, honestly, very generic, and I probably should change that up. And that's something that I'm going to get an information on. The second thing is server event processor, so it's going to send actual information. So the first one is just storing some abstraction that will store the information within a memory of browser, which would be like for weird just front-end testing. The second thing is obviously sending the information, and it's using very, very old and very, very nasty thing, which is called XML HTTP request. I'm not pretty sure that everyone can remember that bit because that was very, very long time ago, even before, it's definitely before me, right? I'm a young man, and the entire Ajax, as you can remember, the ugliest aberration and the ugliest shortcut, the ugliest acronym that was done for the IT industry that we've known, right? So you know what the Ajax is. So Ajax, it's an interesting bit. So Ajax stands for, I hope they write it right. Right, asynchronous. Fine so far, right? JavaScript. That's weird because JavaScript is actually JavaScript, not JavaScript, but fine. And the next one is, behold yourself, and. Oh, sorry. And. Do-do-do-do, hold on for that bit. XML. What the heck is going on here? It's like Ajax, really, asynchronous JavaScript and XML. So my first question is, why the heck it's not JavaScript? So AJS X, fine. And why we're using conjunction as a using a capital word? It should be A, So it should be like pro at the most weird case, it should be like that. And an XML. So here's the thing. I can't remember who were using XML apart from the SOAP requests. Does someone remember that thing? No one actually. And fucking hell, it's like no one was using XML and no one is using XML anymore. So that's the worst acronym in just IT industry that we've came up with. It's like no, that's not something that we should use at all. Anyway, right, so here's the simplest. Whoa, we lost focus for a while. Yeah, obviously about the AJAX thing. Cool. So here's the thing. So the XML HTTP request, and we are opening the post. Obviously, we are going to get an event action, and event action will be upvoted, well, voted, like or dislike. Sorry, I couldn't remember the action name, but yeah, we'll get to that. It's like and dislike, and then we are setting he request header, which is will be content type. We're looking for. We're actually looking for application JSON, obviously, and we are sending. Well, we are sending the application JSON, and we're sending the request for far away. Yeah, so we are just send over the internet. That's not maybe the best method name. Well, sorry, function name. Sorry, JavaScript programmers. And that's not maybe the best thing that I've came up with. It's like send over the really, but fine. So yeah, so that's the server event processor. As you can see, the local event processor is the similar one, but it's not doing anything. It's not sending the over in the internet. It's not sending it even to directly to my ass. So let's go with the implementation. So it's going to get a processor, obviously, and I've got like a few classes about the events, and as you can see. So I've got three classes: dislike, like dislike, and the general event, like abstract class. And I'm getting a timestamp here. So in terms of some sort of, and I wouldn't, I'm not pretty sure what's your perspective on that, but I wouldn't say that it's prototyping. It's definitely not a prototyping. It's like calling a the other constructor, the maybe the base class from the inherited one. So yeah, so here's we are changing the action name. So essentially we're not introducing any interaction with the object. It's going to be like a plain data structure. And yeah, and we've got like a function that it will go to with a process event. And yeah, and this, here's an init information, and init information is going to do the obviously hook up on the onClick events, and it's using once again plain JavaScript. I mean vanilla JS. Someone will say that it's Node.js. No one will say that, but yeah, but this is the entire thing. So. It's essentially, I've tried to do as much as generic as possible. Maybe that wasn't the best idea, although I could create it just one class that will send the request over, and that's probably the best way. However, if I will think about the reusability and testing phase, I was doing like a plain information, because I was the most important bit, what I was interested in. Was these buttons and these effects. That was like I probably have the right information, the click event, like a touch one, because I had to test it on the my phone as well, because this is the entire case that someone will use that phone. No, they won't have the application itself on the desktops. Because during the presentation, it's not really possible to have one, and yeah, and that's gonna be the most important thing. And many people are actually, especially software developers, and with all due respect, but if we are not thinking about things top to the bottom, I mean, like, the interface is the most important thing in the entire application. Even if it's ugly, it's not about, it has to have a purpose, right? And there is no, it doesn't make sense to create the bottom up approach. Like, we're going to think that what kind of classes we have, what kind of data structures we are supporting, and that kind of thing. No, fuck no, that's not, it's not that important. The important bit is to prepare the interface that is going to be served, that people will use, rather than having the proper information, because that's not going to be tested. The interface is going to be tested. That's the thing that we can say, hey, are you going to use that thing? And just showing them up and just clicking around, and let's see how it looks like. It's still bad, but well, I mean, responsive design mode. Yeah, so that's going to be something like that. So essentially, regardless to the phone sizes, is going to be like two buttons on the website. So essentially, if you're having the conversation, well, where you're listening to presentation, you're clicking on, it's also emits bullshit and stuff like that. It's not going to be like, well, something more important than that. And but yeah, that's the important layer, I think. That's my during my the entire experience on the software engineering, it's like, it's always all about bloody interfaces. It's nothing about backend. No one fucking cares about the backend. If you're going to do it well, I mean, fine. It's gonna to be okay with future developers that is going to come after you. Well, they will eventually, but yeah, they are going to use that application later on, and they will just work on it as it follows. But on the other hand, the interface is something that you can test, that you something that you can give a user and say that, well, that's maybe the saving thing is not really working. However, cheers, very appreciate. Well, the saving thing is not really working. But you can play with it, right? You can have fun with it. Well, this one, it's not that important. Sorry, I have to drink a few liquids, 'cause that's a doctor prescription. All right, I'm back. I hope that you've got the same feeling about that, and that's something that you can play with. That's something that you can show to your business. Well, business doesn't really care about that kind of thing, and if they do, that's absolutely fine. That's the best thing. However, they are not the beneficent. They're not using it. They're not going to have the same perspective as customers, as users, as someone, as a, essentially people that were using, will use that application if they're not using it yet. Right. So that was the front end bit. Let's see on the styling. I'm not the most the best person working on styling, so that's something that I came up with. That's probably something not right, that I've got height and a 48%, but I can remember that it wasn't working these days. But anyway, yeah, so these are the things. And if you're talking about index HTML, it's not going to be SEO compliant so far, because that's an application that people will use in just audience room. It doesn't have to be searchable. I haven't think about accessibility yet, because that's something that I would rather try to work out later on. Yeah, that kind of thing, but essentially the HTML code's quite semantically, I believe, proper at some point and correct. It's like I've got one class that I'm saying that the button is like, and I've got a second button that I think that is dislike it, and when I'm saying that it's something, I mean it. Okay. Cool. So that's all from the first phase of having the thing described. Okay, and that's something that I came up after probably 3 hours, and explaining that maybe 4 hours and the of work, and the explaining that took more than an hour. Which is very, very bad, honestly. And yeah, and I should work on that more later on. But yeah, and here's the part when I'm stopping and I have to get a break to just, fulfill the liquids and stuff like that. And after that, we'll go with an implementation. That will take 2 minutes for getting in a loop, and the second 2 minutes for having my just tea. Be right back. By the way, if you've got any questions, if you've got any feedback on that, if you do like that or don't like, just put it in the comment. That's the first thing. And the second thing, I would like to invite you to my blog, which is PuraDaWid.pro. So my first name and last name, which is PuraDaWid.pro, and I really appreciate that you will join that up and see what kind of blog post I've got there. Okay, be right back. Hold on. All right, okay. Welcome back. We're having a very psycho stream on the programming topic. No, I'm just kidding. That's a during ball boring, boring dull, boring and dull thing that we're going to have here, which is programming with nothing. No, just kidding. Right. So I've seen that someone asked the question. Someone asked the question, is the I believe the Larry King 887 887 asked about what's better, assembly or Java? And that's honestly very general question. It's like and I'm going to answer that at some point. However, let's start from the beginning. So what's the Java is? Java essentially just was created for being an intranet, well, not an internet, but a web, especially web, and serving the HTTP requests and stuff like that language. So essentially that's portable, and that's going to be having the JVM. So essentially the difference between JVM and the rest of the world, let's say that, because we are not taking into account a C sharp and all the just virtual machines. So that's essentially something that is going to have. Right, Carol, cheers, mate. Yeah, okay. Cool. I will just find out if that's going to be something that's so Carol just sent me a message that I have to check my blog if that's the bloody Discus plugin's working. Anyway, best regards, Carol, with love. Anyway, so yeah, so so I'm answering the question Java assembly. And for someone that is not really doing the IoT thing, so Internet of Things, or is not doing embedded systems, I would say that try to learn Java in the first place. I mean, you will get more money, that's the first thing, and you will get more employment. That's definitely a more broader market for Java programmers than assembly things. And the differences between using a virtual machine as a place that Java runs. So essentially Java is something, it's a code that is compiled, it's getting compiled into a bytecode, which is essentially assembly for JVM. And if you are doing assembly, it's essentially a code that will work for the specific architecture, for the specific architecture of processor in general. So I would rather told you to learn Java, definitely. However, and that's the thing that I've discovered recently. I was doing some sort of research. What kind of programming languages are actually efficient, right? And easy enough to learn. And obviously Python popped up. But I think that Python, it's fine. It's definitely fine. But still, it's not that kind of scriptic language I would found as useful. I mean, it's absolutely useful. Just don't beat me. Your AI masters and stuff like that. However, I think that the entire hype on Python is coming from exactly machine learning thing. And honestly, it's not that simple language. I wouldn't recommend to learn Java as a first language for programming at all. I mean, it has a lot of drawbacks. It's not essentially object oriented, so we can't learn an object oriented programming. On the other hand, you cannot learn any other approach of programming. Honestly, it's like it's something that you will get money for, but that's not essentially something that you wanted to learn programming with. So I would recommend, and that's really important and this really fun language, called Lua, L-U-A. And it's essentially very simple in terms of, it's a script language. It's very popular on Linux machines, so you can install it in 1 second. It doesn't require any some sort of libraries and stuff like that. It's very, very fast, and you can start with that. You can start writing code with it, and having fun. And essentially, there are not things like classes. There aren't things like threads in general. They're not things like some sort of sophisticated things. That's why I would recommend JavaScript if that wouldn't be that crippled in terms of drawbacks that it has. However, the entire thing that it's working on the every single machine, because everyone has a browser, and it's essentially working. It's a good language to learn. Lua first. Second, JavaScript, maybe, if you're looking for understanding how the thing's working, and especially if you want to learn functional programming. But Java is something that you would like to learn, but I wouldn't recommend that as a something that you should learn at the first place, right? So the entire problem, and that's I think the entire programming industry is suffering with, is that we don't actually learn the right things in the first place. I mean, we should, and that's definitely something that we should learn. Is thinking as a programmer, thinking about how we are going to structure our code, and after that we should think about how it's actually how the code should be created in terms of maintainability. I mean, like, I've got that bunch of code, whatever, it's microservice, micro bullshit, or just monolith, and how I'm going to change it? What are the vectors of change that I'm thinking about in the future? Right? Is it going to be just a static string or something like that? And I think that the entire industry, the entire learning society about programming is wrong about teaching irrelevant. Actually, from a programmer perspective, details in the first place. So if you ever, so raise your hand if you are doing in the first class of your university, I don't know, wherever school you finished, raise your hand if you are learning C or C++ language in the first place, or Pascal. It's like, fucking hell, really? Especially C, right? And it was very, very hard for many, many people to understand that you can get a wrong pointer to the function. You can get wrong pointer to the structure. How you can get the value from a pointer and the pointer from a value. Then blah, 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 blah. It was essentially mad. And from my perspective, these people that were actually teaching the C from the beginning for the people that weren't familiar with the programming in the first place, they were doing very, very severe damage. Very severe damage, because people are actually were like, oh my fucking God, I don't understand that. I don't understand the memory model, right? But it's not about memory model in the first place. It's not about how the pointers are working. It's not about how registers and x86 are working. It's not about that kind of thing. It's about thinking first how you're going to specify your program, right? So that was kind of, yeah. I'm pissed off on that, because I think that the entire programming industry is doing severe damage for the newcomers that are trying to learn languages that are not used anymore. That's the first thing. Or they are quite broken because of their specification, because of their the entire. Do you know how many things are actually happening in Java? Because it was introduced in Java 1.0, and essentially we've got, just to be aware, it's like Java 11. Backward compatibility, it does make sense. Okay, it's that does make sense, but for God's sake. Right, so enough of my bullshitting around the Java and that kind of programming things, and sorry for that. And yeah, and let's go to the actual implementation. So what we are going to do right now is to implement a statistics. All right. So we are going to have like an information. So in terms of, we are going to store. So the information is getting stored right now, and we can think about that as done. However, what we want to introduce. Is the information how many people were voting during the session? That's the first thing. The second thing is how many likes were done during that session, and we want to know how many dislikes were done during the session, which are quite lame things. However, let's go to tests, obviously, because we have to start with tests. If someone is starting without a test, it's no one but dual programmer and that kind of sentence Uncle Bob says all the time. And if you know a bit about test driven development, and or because that's the bit that I hate about that. TDD, driven development or driven design? It's design or development. I can't remember. So if you can remember, just let me know in the comments. Because that's probably that I'm missing. So, yeah, anyway. Yeah, and if you're listening to person like Uncle Bob, is like, oh, holy moly, if I'm not writing a test in the first place, nothing more than a dual programmer, which is kind of true in terms of if you are doing very, very plain things. However, if you're doing something that's it's something like interface, and that's the entire thing, right? So if you're doing an interface, and I mean like not an interface in Java way, but an actual interface, a web UI or different interface, what you're going to do is a prototype first. You're not going to write a test first. No, that's not going to happen. What can actually happen is that you will think about the test case, which will be like something that you can get with or you cannot, but that's absolutely different thing. So if someone is actually thinking about should I write tests before implementation, I would say yes. However, and it's always in solace, however, however, you're doing a first iteration of interface of your, or you're doing a proof of concept that's going to be an actual thing. What's up? Bloody cat. Anyway, yeah, and if you're doing the proper implementation of interface, that's not probably something that you will work with. Okie dokie dokie doke. So let's start from writing a test, because obviously it's all about tests, and yeah. Yeah, and we've got actual somewhat of that kind of test. I couldn't remember that if we'll have that one or not. So the test says test reading starts with one like and dislike from different people. So yeah, so given we've got like a voting builder which is happening with all type of repository, I should probably create a provider for that, or at least a provider method. Because that's something that I should hide from a test case perspective, as it's not really a part of the test case. It's a just this configuration part of the application itself. But let's focus on the test first, and after that we'll refactor that. And yeah, and we are getting report facade, which is the facade that is actually getting information from. So it's like a query engine. So we can think about the voting report facade as a query part, the query bit of the domain, and the voting facade itself is a write domain, is just if you're thinking about comment query separation, right? So the voting facade is a comment. The voting report facade is something that's doing a query. Okay. So here's the thing: we are getting a statistics. Okay. So, but the second thing, we are getting a facade. So we are getting a write and read facades as different objects. However, it's going to be the same object underneath, probably, but we don't know from the test perspective, right? So we're using a builder to instantiate the builder, and well, we're using a builder to instantiate the facades, but we don't know what's the relation between these two, and that separation is done for two different reasons. So the first one, the first reason is that we are going to have we are going to provide the information about different. So we are going maybe we're going to split it up into two different instances. Maybe we're going to split it up into two different channels. So there is a channel in and there is a channel out, which is absolutely fine, which is actually happening in CQRS, Greg Young. But from the other perspective, it's like we probably, and that's the architectural decision I've made here, and that was the crucial one, that the voting in and voting out will be handled by different, absolutely different front ends. So, because it's happening because of two reasons. So the first reason is that there are different requirements in terms of non-functional requirements, obviously, in terms of performance especially. So I don't really care about reporting. Is that going to be quite heavy lifting or not? However, I really do care when the voting is happening. So I can imagine that I've got like a machine that it's trying to handle 500, 1,000 requests per minute, per probably even often. And that might be the problematic way. So I just opened that's some kind of premature optimization, fine, but and that's the entire thing that if you know that guy, and his name is hold on, I can't remember his name honestly. So the guy is something. He has absolutely different point of view than Uncle Bob does, and that's bloody hell, I forgot the name. It's like I can't remember. Anyway, so yeah, so he's it's really hard. I have to Google that for God's sake. Sorry, but it's really important for me. And I don't want to forget the guy, because he's doing a really decent job in terms of being a quite conscious He's Koplayan, but Koplin. Hold on a second. I couldn't remember the name. It's way too late. Let's walk in the hallway. But I'm not making excuses at all. I'm like, no. It's not an excuse. I just forgot his name. Yeah, Jim. Jim. James Complian. Complian. Coplien. So he has absolutely different perspective, point of views regarding regarding the optimization and taking the well, maybe not the optimization itself, but taking the architectural decisions. So he's saying that it's not about delaying an a decision the latest moment you can have, but it's all about having the right decisions as soon as possible it to make them. So you can think about things, and this is a different approach that Scrum is saying about, right? It's like you're not delaying the decision to the latest point, but you're trying to pull it up as soon as possible to make that decision, to gather the required data for that point in time, and that's actually that's the decision I've made in terms of having that kind of split it off as it's going to be used by different users, right? And that's the second thing. So the presenter, let's name his her him or her presenter, he's going to handle the entire comment sorry query operations, right? He's going as a first person, he's going to get the entire knowledge about the session, right? He want to get feedback. He want to get feedback. So we are not going to do a thing like a query for every single user, for audience. But on the other hand, audience is actually someone that, well, not someone, but bunch of people that are doing the right thing, and I mean writing. So they're going to send the feedback further on. So that's the entire thing that I'm going to. That's why I'm going to split that facade up into two places. Oh, right. So I have to do that kind of sessions more often, like once a week, probably, and get pissed once a week properly, and think about that, and maybe the elaboration skill of mine will be quite extended, because I'm trying to explain basic things, and it's like I've got a feeling that it's taking me an ages. All right. Anyway. So we are going to, and here's some sort of helping method that it's a static method that is getting. I'm going to get a plain person of one. So I'm going to get one person, the second person, the first person, the second person, and they are going to vote true false, so like this, like this, like this, like. The new data is getting created every single time because that's not the point that I'm taking care about the time at all. So that's the what's happening, what's the action, and the verification is that I'm getting to count the number of people, and the number of people is two, and the total votes is four. So in terms of that test, I've got tests already written here, and my proposition is to find out what's happening underneath the implementation, go through the code and find the test that will break that up. So let's go through that. If that will work, we'll go to the representation problem. So we'll write a control. Well, we will write probably an integration test that will read the will read, but it won't obviously because that will fail. Read the information, and after that, we're going to get an information in the front end, which will be happening with some sort of chart. Probably, or the in the first place, we'll use just plain data without writing any chart. Cool. So let's find out what the statistics for that is and how it's actually working. Right. So, where's the implementation? That's a voting class. Okay. So the statistics are as follows. It's getting all from repository. Very, very effective. I love that. And it's getting and returning the statistics object, which will have size. And after that is going to find out how many users are using that bit, which is fine. That's absolutely right. But if I'm looking at this, what I'm missing is the number of votes that is going to be disliked and the number of votes that are going to upvote the thing, right? So maybe in terms of having just don't do it at home. That's not very safe. No copying tests. Test reading starts when with one like and dislike from different people. From different people count dislikes. So here's the thing that I'm going to get different assertion. So I'm going to also that. Voting repo for site. That kind of simple thing. Going to create a method which will be number of dislikes. Fine. So right now it should not work at all. I mean, like running the method will just say that hey, there's a compilation error. Fine. We've got a statistic issue, and these are all about missing the object implementation, which is number of dislikes, fine, and it's getting me a null. And normally, and that's the example from many, many TDD books, is like, I will show you that up because that's unbelievable thing. So normally no one will do that, but I'm returning here too, obviously, because that's my test is all about. I'm just returning to, and I'm going through having the fun with that kind of thing. And after that, I'm going back to the test itself, and I'm going to get this test in place. I'm going to copy that. Well, do not do it at home, but yeah, whatever. It's getting late, and I'm going to get a deadline, obviously. No, I'm not, but yeah. By the way, if you will be happy to join this project, and I would really, really love that. Just let me know. Let me know in the comments. Let me know in private message or email, or just go to my blog, and there will be like thing and just put the comments as long as we'll get the discuss working back. I think that's working, but yeah, I will check that up. And yeah, and I will go. And you will joining the project. I'm absolutely fine with going through the code once again. No, just kidding. I wouldn't go that boring. But yeah, but let me just know, and we'll just find out the job for you. Cause that might be quite dull right now. But if that will be going to a cloud, and we'll actually do and the first prototypes and the first testing for an actual presentation, and we'll add features like showing the information during the presentation already on the screen and stuff like that. That will be quite interesting, and I will find more than one apart from me person that will use that bit. So yeah, so let's go with that. Anyway, yeah. So different people count dislikes. People are not counting dislikes, but yeah. So here's the point. I'm going to change that up into something like this. It's fine. Someone can just get three false. Three negative things, and I'm going to have like that's an actual, well, I can't remember that if that's an example, but definitely there are examples like put it put in the first place, put the fixed number that will just fix your code, and I think that is coming from the entire approach is coming from it's coming from the things that you're actually going to be kind of happy that the code is passing, and that's making your brain giving you some sort of hormones that they're going to say, you ha, you lucky man, you're going to be a real rich tonight. But no, that's not really what it is, I believe, at least. However, the Facebook approach, I mean the Facebook like marketing stuff, is quite bothering. I mean the entire scrolling, the entire liking and that kind of things are actually very, very subconscious, and they're just putting us into expected, but was a three. Oh no, how that happened? How did it happen? I've got no idea. Right, so getting back to that, so how I'm going to sort that up. So in terms of I can get, not pretty sure that the statistics in terms of value object is something that I'm looking for. Maybe that I should change that up in a while. However, yeah. However, let's do it. Let's do it that way. I'm doing it wrong. I'm doing it wrong from many, many reasons. The first one that I'm not really using the IntelliJ functionality. That will just auto-generate that member. That's definitely wrong. Don't do it. However, the most important bit is that I should change that and just to change it to dislikes. Yeah, and this one as well. Right. Cool. So that's the thing, and that's the thing here. That's immutable class. I'm not really sure that I should have the well, immutable is fine. Absolutely, that's something that we're looking for. However, hold on. It's absolutely that we're looking for. However, the entire thing is that I probably should calculate the that things and just get the copy in the first place, the copy of information that I'm looking for. And just change it to the statistics here. Otherwise, I'm going to have like quite a lot of calculations in the voting class rather than having it separate for the statistics. But yeah, so what I can do here is like the same thing. So if you're familiar with, and I believe you are familiar with Java streams, it's the same as well, map and map filter reduce and probably flat. I can remember, is there a flat map or flat left in JavaScript? But yeah, it's happening there as well. So it's very, very similar. It's the problem is with handling exceptions within lambdas, but yeah, but that's similar construction to arrow function. Yeah, anyway, so what we are happening what's happening here is that we are going to map things, but the first thing that I would do here is get events and filter them out. Filtering them out, looking for positive or negative. Actually, I was looking for negative. Okay, so yeah, so that's a negation, and I'm doing a map distinct count. No, I don't really care about that. I do care about counting the number. Okay, running the test. Right, that's working. All right. So here's the first bit, and the second bit would be like another labor of that kind of thing. However, I could do. So let's get back to the test. So let's get back to the test, and the test is quite dull, isn't it? And what I'm going to change here is I would add more effects. Let's do it like this. That's something that I shouldn't do normally, but I'll refactor that later on. So count votes type. All right. I'm not gonna have to play the same game again because because that's not a right thing in my understanding to do. I mean, the tests should be quite dull, fine, but they shouldn't be like very, very naive. That's my understanding, that there shouldn't be like are they going to, yeah, there should be at least some sort of trust that we are just not being a scapegoat of the entire gig. Cool. Further, Captain America. Right, so we need to create the method. Whoa, that's hard. It's not going to be object, sweetheart. It's going to be int and int in the matter as well. So what happened in statistics here? Right. I missed that bit. Yep. Okay. And here's the thing I was talking about. So I don't. I'm not going to put the other information back to the voting class. I'm going to assume that we've got like a number of votes which are positive and negative, and essentially there are going to be right that kind of simple thing. So let's run one again. There is by the way, if someone will say that, hey, there's a security reason because there might be happening the overload or whatever. I don't really care at this point, honestly. I mean, let's go into the agile. It's all about agile, isn't it? Yeah, so that's working fine. We are getting somewhere. Cool. So in terms of that, as long as we've got like an information how many dislikes and how many likes were happening on the this the backend level, let's do the bottom up, obviously. Why not? So we have to think about that we are going to have a different application for getting the results as a query. All right. And yeah, that's kind of bothering, isn't it? It's like how we are going to start this up. Are we going to use a different Spring Boot application? Maybe. Maybe not. Hold on. Right, lovely. Okie doke, doke, doke then. So, what we are going to do, and that's quite a bold thing, is that we are going to have the same thing on the controller. So we probably are going to use a different controller, obviously, and we'll just render the information that is not going to be index. At all, it's going to be like a query or something like that. And yeah, that's the approach here. So let's start from a scratch. So here's a fundamental thing that I'm going to do. So I'm going to start the application that is going to be presenter information. It's not going to be voter anymore. So voter, in terms of gathering data, is done already. We can think about that. It's done in terms of the basic thing that it should do. Okay, and but the second thing, which is gathering data, is not done yet at all. Definitely at all. I mean, like there is no even functionality for that. So let's go through that. Let's go through that. Let's do the important thing. On the other hand, my thought is that tests should be quite GUI. As a GUI, I mean graphical user interface, obviously. It's going to be quite aware of GUI. I mean, it's not about having the GUI itself tightly coupled with the domain objects. However, that might be like a port for the GUI itself. So the point is that that if you think about the result, which is the statistics, right? So this interface, I would say that it's going to be a GUI. This data is going to be displayed. I don't really care how it's going to be displayed, right? But these informations are the most important ones for a user. So yeah, so let's go with that. I'm not going to implement security yet. I mean, like authentication, authorization, whatever. That's the bit I would leave it to the next probably session if that will happen. I believe it will happen because I will get a better setup of the entire environment, probably the better microphone and stuff like that, as that is the first very very first streaming that I did like ever. So yeah, so that was that's a quite experience for me, a real experience, and we'll go further with that. But yeah, but that's the entire point, that we are creating an interface, and that interface is going to be a graphical user interface as well. I'm like, here's the number of total votes that you received, mate, and here's the number of people that were attending in your voting, and here's the number of dislikes, and there is number of likes. Very, very fundamental thing. What I'm thinking in general is like a chart that you're getting the information over the time, right? So that's the first place of your of the voting, and you said something silly, and someone just started to dislike things, and you can see that it's going to be, oh, that's a bullshit, 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 bullshit. Oh, but you said something really important and really interesting, so you're getting upvoted a bit. So you're safe. So no one will kill you during that presentation, probably, and after that. Yeah, so that kind of thing, that's going to be quite interesting, and that's going to be the next session. During this session, we'll just create a fundamental application for, well, not an application, but the serving of information for the voter. Alrighty. So the entire problem we've got right now is that resources are having one template, and this very one template has absolutely no information about what it is. So we can think about that's really, really write only thing. So we are just sending the really necessary, just the fundamental information about how to do the proper REST post request, which is absolutely fine, and we will go with that further on. However, if we are thinking about how this template is going to be linked with the information, that's a good question. I can't remember how it was done. Probably you will help me with that a bit. Let's see the controller itself as the first place. We've got an outer wire, fine, two request methods, fine, REST controller, fine. So it's not going to serve the information. So probably if I will create a new template. Okay, so if I'm going to like a statistics, so it's going to render that statistic template as well. So I'm getting rid of the buttons. I'm saying statist full. Right, I'm going to run the application. So the Spring Boot is actually running up. It's very, very interesting moment in my life, honestly. Spring Boob. Okay, never mind. Yeah, it's starting to working. All right, let's get back to the website. By the way, if you haven't seen, the website is down. YouTube movie that's done. Years ago, honestly, that's a kind of good thing to watch. Okay, so the templates are statistics.html, right? While I will if I fuck. So why it's not working? Because the actuator fine. What about the index though? Probably it's all about security itself. I mean, like, no, it's no index, no. I don't believe that it's done on statistics, but we have got 403. That might be the other configuration of security though. Let's go to the security settings and yeah. Right, so here's the I probably should use the regex pattern. Why it's not working? Statistics HTML is a huh. Okay. I don't think that it requires a rerun thing, but let's see about that. By the way, if you've got any feedback on this session, how it's going, why it's going wrong, why it's going good, why it's not going bad as you expected, fine, just send me in a comment. I'm really, really keen on looking for that feedback and improving that session later on. I mean the next sessions, because that's something that I really, really do appreciate, feedback, an honest one. If that's like it's shit, just send me a message. I'm absolutely fine with that kind of information, although I would rather know why it's going to be a shit rather than it's just general shit. Cool. And if that's actually something that you're interested in, let me know as well. I mean, that's definitely more appreciate information, wink wink. That's no, it's just kidding, it's equally appreciated, but yeah, that's also something important that I'm looking for, right? But that's not really working. Okay, fine. Right. Cool, so it looks like I guess so. It looks like it's not going to serve that one. Not pretty sure, should I just rebrand the application or not? I don't think so, however. That's a Spring for God's sake. That's saying a lot. I mean, it's saying that I'm not really. It's saying that, well, the statistics, maybe there is some sort of. On, come on. Cat is going somewhere. Yep, using me as a just place to jump off. Yeah, but that's an interesting thing. So it's like saying that statistics HTML, yeah, it's forbidden. And if I'm just saying that, well, maybe you should just get the statistics. It's saying no fucking way. H44. So if that's 404, that means the entire mapping with the template isn't working, which is why, I mean the request mapping, fine, but can I just say here that I'm going to get some specific template? No. That's obviously not what's happening here. So I need something else. I need probably router. I'm not pretty sure about that, but static Spring MVC auto configuration. So I'm reading that from documentation. So it says that Spring Boot provides auto configuration for Spring MVC that works well with most applications. Fuck off, really. The auto configuration adds following features on top of Spring defaults as follows. Inclusion of content negotiation view resolver. Content negotiation view resolver. That's the important bit that I think that I'm missing. Cool. Let's see what it is. So that's a view resolver implementation. For example, if the request path is view HTML, the view resolver will look for the file that has text HTML content type based on the HTML file extension. A request for view with a view with the text XML across. Right, so it looks like the content negotiation view resolver is definitely going to work with my assumption. that the statistics HTML should work as charm, but it isn't working at some because of some sort of ridiculous thing. Statistics. No, I'm just thinking about that. I made a mistake. Some sort of. Well, hold on. Statistics HTML. Content Negotiation Manager. That's a weird thing, honestly. Yeah, it's not gonna work. And there is an information within the same documentation that static index HTML support, whatever that means. Bean name view resolver. That's also interesting thing. That's the older bit that I found. Creepy. That's something I was missing, probably, in terms of. Okay, so yeah, so probably what I've missed is that I'm going to render the proper static information. But I shouldn't probably. I mean, it's a wrong. It's definitely wrong that I'm going to say like, let's do it just an exercise. If that's going to be like post, it's not going to be post but get, and that's not going to be. It's going to be statistics. I shouldn't put the first thing is that I shouldn't put it here, right? So that's the first information that I shouldn't do. The f second thing is that so So the question is where I should put it, right? So the answer is, so the answer is that I should put it in a separate controller, and I will do that as soon that will work. I mean, if that's gonna to work as a statistics, I'm gonna to rewrite this and put it into different controller, because that's an important bit. I'm not going to have to stay with the same controller for all of the views and all of the routing stuff. That's essentially wrong approach. Right, so that's running right now. Let's see about that. Is it working? No. No. Ah, for God's sake, I forgot to change the security settings from HTML to statistics. But still, that should work anyway. If that's not working, it's probably because I've got some more troubles here. But that's all right. I mean, shit happens, right? There are probably more possibilities of getting that stuff sorted out in the spring. I wouldn't be happy if that has to be just created in an XML file at all. I mean, really? but yeah. I mean, the good thing is that it looks like at least that bin name view resolver is going to sort out the view based not an XML file, but on the bin name file. I think that's, let me know if that's happening, that the entire clicky clack effects that I'm doing during the typing is actually getting you in your audio. If that's happening, that has to be sorted out later on. For God's sake, what I'm saying later anyway. Yep. Right. So it looks like the controller should return the if that's if I'm asking for statistics, and I'm just sending that information. It should load statistics, probably .xml. The entire MVC thing is something that also is hold on. Really, me. REST controller. Carl, that's a REST controller. That's a good question, though. Yeah, have to get me. Right. So, yeah, that's So probably I should use the end model and view response or view response. Yeah. Gotcha. Yeah, I will do that in a moment. So Carol just suggested to. No, I'm pretty sure you're right. So Carol suggested to move it to the control, well, to the controller instead of REST controller. We see about that, but in the first place, I would like to do the take a shot. Because that's the view and model or something like that. Model and view. No. Cool. Yeah, good point. Anyway, I will try to move that anyway to the different controller. Not really happy about that one. Not at the first stage, at least. Cool. So let's name it. How we should name it? Presenter controller. No, that would be dull name. Before. Yeah, that's a dual anyway, but the heck. That should work, I guess. Control is not something that we are having. Testing config does have the site and statistics, fine. Voting builder, fine. Yep. Without HTML. Carol, you can join the chat, I think. That would be quite helpful. I mean, like, I'm trying to go through the messenger as well, but I could disable it, you know. No, just kidding. Cool. So without HTML, then. Where is it? Yeah, that's a good point. Hold on, the security settings are probably most important thing here. Not pretty sure that will work, but eventually we'll use star here, which won't be the best solution anyway. But yeah, and this is the entire thing of the programming industry. It's like we're struggling with technical problems, and yeah. And it's coming because I don't know, honestly, a spring. So that's something that I have to learn a bit. Nope. Something's happening. Right, so that's the entire thing. Okay, so right. So here's the thing. I wonder if that will work. Oh no, that's probably just it's 403, so I believe that's a problem with just putting it here, or I should rerun the application, the entire application. It's wrong, but nope. Interesting. So it will work without HTML. If I would do that kind of thing. So there is no auto negation then. I would rather stick to with an extension thing as it is something that as this something that I would admire in an application that will return HTML every single time I'm asking for HTML, it will return something else if I'm asking for someone else. Apart from the post, because post might be a different thing, I think. However, yeah, it's just the same story. So statistics are not working anymore. Fine, but what about HTML? Yep, it's working. Thanks, Carol. Thank you, Carol. I owe you a train of beers, train of bloody pints. Right, so here's the entire point that we've got like information from here. So by default, I think it's a flux, but I'm not pretty sure about that. Let me just check with the documentation. And aren't you running out of time? I believe no, but yeah, we've got 10 minutes. Not something that I'm happy about, but So there are two things that I can do here. So the first one is to write a static application. I mean, like a static template that will get the information from a REST service, which is the first thing I can do. However, the second one is like creating a template that will render the information directly. And I'm just thinking about which one would be better, honestly. So the first. So the first one will work well if I'm going to yeah, but I'm just thinking about how complex these two solutions are. So in terms of processing, in terms of that, what's happening in the browser. If I'm loading the page, I'm going to load the information afterwards. It's not something that I would expect to do. On the other hand, the implementation of having the REST services that will save, well, that will store, well, will serve the data will be easier and better. I don't know, honestly. Any strong opinion on that? Anyone? What's better? Let's say single page application or just dynamic templates, let's say. Which one might be better? Is there anything that can win that race? Technically speaking, I would rather go with. With REST. However, is there anything that I would say that it's going to be better than that one? Than doing it on the. It's better to remain with T client, right? I mean, thin client and a thick server in that case. Definitely, I don't want to. What I don't want to do is to process the data on the client. There's definitely something that I wouldn't do, and that's a wrong approach, essentially. However, on the other hand, right. Carol, nice nickname, but yeah. Yeah, good point. I would go with the template. Yeah, me too. I think that's yeah, that's better. That's better approach. Okay then, so we've got like there's another question then. So I hate that question honestly, because that's not something that I will be happy about regardless the answer. So which template engine are we going to choose? Is it going to be like a Webflux, which is used by default, or it's going to be something slightly different? No idea. I would go with Webflux. Okay, anyway, right. So here's the wrap up of this session. So it turns out I've got a really big struggle with the Spring once again, because I just haven't touched the Spring for a year. So that's something that I was kind of confused. Fine, but the other thing is that session was all right, I think. There were just a few people, which is all right, at that stage. I would like to thank you all guys, for having that kind of adventure with me. And yeah, I would ask you to go to the to my blog, which is puradavid.pro, which is PuraDavid .pro, and leave a comment there if you will happy with the next session, which will happen anyway, in the next week. Probably, well, not the next week, probably the next after, as I'm going to unfortunately a business trip. So let's do the next session, and let's do the next step of this project afterwards. I've got to thank everyone. So have a nice night if you're going to go to bed, as I am going to, or have a nice beer if you're going to have another one. Cool. Thanks everyone, and take care. Oh, and if you're actually like this channel, and if you're going to watch me later on, don't forget to click follow, and that will get you an update where I'm doing the next time. Cheers, everyone. Bye, have a nice night. Goodbye.